Hi, I'm Jen with Pepper Harrow. Today we're going to be talking about how to start celosia from seed. Celosia, it's all the same thing. No worries, we all know what we're talking about here. We really, really love this flower here at Pepper Harrow. We use it in all of our bouquets all season long, and we also highly value celosia as a dried flower. And you'll see that we actually dry a lot of celosia here on the farm. And why do we dry it? We use it for fall wreaths. We also use it in the middle of winter to do holiday wreaths. It looks absolutely gorgeous, especially the Chester Copper Pot variety that many of you absolutely love. We also like to do a burgundy celosia that absolutely looks stunning for those wreaths as well. But today, the two celosias we're going to be talking about are the Rainbow Sherbet and also Chester Copper Pot. Those are the two seeds that we actually sold online this year, and we're going to be talking a little bit more about how we get those seeds started. So let's get started. I'm starting with a 72 cell tray here, and I have it filled with seed starting medium. We'll link below to tell you where we source all of these things from so that you can easily find them as well. So check the box below. All the things that we're going to be talking about here will be linked so that it can help you find these things to do your own seed starting. But now that I have my 72 cell tray all ready to go and seed starting mediums in it, I'm going to start by getting my seed starting medium a little bit moist. So I'm using a spray bottle because it's easier to work with. You can certainly use a garden hose if you have access to that, but especially if you tend to overwater, this is the way to go. This will make sure that you don't overwater too much. It just gives it a little bit of moisture to be able to keep that cell nice and moist. Moisture is the key when you do seed starting. So I can kind of tell it's not too heavy, it's not too light. If it's too light, obviously it means you need more water. Don't ever let your seedlings dry out. That's very critical. But you also don't want your seedlings drowning in water to where it's like heavy and hard to pull this tray up. You want it to be a nice in between, nice and moist. That's the key to make sure that we get these seeds germinated. For the celosia seed that we're going to be starting today, I'll put it in my hand and I'll show you a close-up of what it kind of looks like. I like to start my celosia seed about 6 to 8 weeks before last frost. This will make sure that they don't get too root-bound, and typically celosia germinates at a little bit higher temperature than the rest of my seeds. So they're one that definitely needs a little bit warmer temperature. I'd say between 75 and 80 degrees is ideal for getting it to germinate. Usually about 75 is the max temperature I can usually get it, but it likes a little bit warmer. So I usually start some other seeds first and then do my celosia a little bit later in my seed starting schedule, if you will. So I'm going to take these seeds and I'm going to put them in my hand. They're really tiny, and again, you probably all know the rule of thumb is the size of the seed dictates how far it goes into the ground. Celosia is a little bit smaller, so we're going to make sure that we don't put it too far down into our seed starting medium. But to start, I'm just going to start by putting it on top of each cell that I'm working with here. Okay, so I've done 3 rows of celosia, and before I do anything, I'm going to just make a little label for it. And instead of saying just celosia, I'm putting Chester because this is Chester Copper Pot. So I have my little Chester tag there. I have my 3 rows noted. I usually put my tag on the last row I ended with, and I always remember that everything to the right of it, I have that particular seed in place. So if you're using one of these trays to do multiple seeds, that's the way to keep track of it. Just remember where you stopped and put your label in that row and keep track that the rest of them are to the right. If you feel more comfortable, put a label in each row. I like to conserve resources. I don't like to use a ton of things, so I usually just put one label to keep track of the rest of the rows that I have a particular seed in. Okay. So my little seeds are in my cells. Instead of covering them or pushing them down into the soil, I'm just going to take my spray bottle and I'm just going to mist them on top. That's going to make the soil just kind of cover that seed a little bit. I don't need to push it in. I don't need to cover it. Celosia seed does need light to germinate, so lightly spraying the top and making sure that you don't bury it too far into the seed starting soil is the way to go. It typically takes celosia about 8 to 14 days to pop up. If your temperature is variable and you can't keep it at a consistent temperature, if it fluctuates a bit, it may take just a smidge longer. But 14 days is usually the max. They usually pop up pretty quickly. And celosia isn't a super challenging seed to start. You just have to remember that you need it to be a little bit warmer, 70 to 75 to 80 degrees, if you can get it there to be able to get it to germinate. I like to keep track of my temperature of my seed starting area by using my digital thermometer. This really tells me what the temperature is at any time of day. It's a highly valuable tool. Now that my seeds are in my tray, I make sure that my seedlings have adequate access to a light source. If you're a home gardener, you just need to have it close to a nice southern-facing window that gets lots of access to the sun. Or if you have a seed starting area in your basement that you have all set up with grow lights, that's perfect. I'm growing in my little propagation house here. It is heated and kept at a consistent temperature, but I don't have my grow lights in, so I'm actually going to hang grow lights up to be able to have these in place. And again, we'll link these grow lights in the box below so that you have access. But grow lights are a great way to supplement your light source for your seedlings to be able to give them light to grow towards. Remember, if you keep these in front of a window, you're going to have to move your tray around once a day. So every day, you're just going to have to move it, move it, move it. If it's this way in front of the window, one day you're going to have it like this. And you're gonna leave it there an entire day. The next day, you're gonna turn it completely 180. So you kind of get the idea. The key is not to have your seedlings stretched towards the light. You want them to grow up. And moving your tray around, especially if it's from one specific light source, your seedlings will try to grow towards the light, and you're going to try to want to prevent that by moving your tray around. All right, so I'm just going to move that back for what we're looking at here. We love using celosia in cut flower bouquets. We use it all year in every bouquet. We like to shift by color, looking at starting some kind of blushier tones in spring and then moving into some of the deeper reds and burgundies for fall. We also like to take it and dry it. So this is actually Chester Copper Pot dried. And you can see this lovely burgundy pink color that we have here. We love to take these dries and use them in fall wreaths, and we especially love using this for holiday wreaths. Over the holidays, this was a popular dried flower that was included in a lot of wreaths for people who came out and made wreaths with us. So keep in mind, you can use it fresh, you can use it dried. It's absolutely, absolutely incredible. And you can see how well it keeps its color, how red and vibrant it is. It's absolutely gorgeous. So this is Chester Copper Pot. I actually don't have an example of the rainbow sherbet. It might fade out a little bit more because it's more of a peachy tone, but the red, especially the burgundy rust color, looks really gorgeous. Once I let my celosia seedlings grow for about 6 to 8 weeks, I'm ready to start the process of hardening them off. I do want to make sure all danger of frost has passed and that there is a consistent warm temperature outside. Celosias are very resistant to any kind of cold. They hate it. So I like to make sure it's nice and warm before I bring them outside. To do the hardening off process, I basically take them from an indoor growing space like this. I transition them outside, and I do that by taking them outside an hour each day. I try to keep them in a place out of direct sunlight and out of an extremely windy condition. Baby seedlings don't like wind and they don't like direct sun, so I try to avoid those things if possible, taking them out on a mild day that's pretty calm. So day one, I'll take them out for an hour. Day two, I'll take them out for 2 hours. Day three, 3 hours. You kind of get the idea. The key is you want to just make sure they're not getting too beaten up outside. You gradually want to transition them outside into the elements, and you'll feel when they're ready by taking your hand and kind of rubbing it on the over the top of the seedlings. They'll feel nice and tough and kind of hard, and that's why it's called hardening off. Once they're hardened off, they're ready to be planted directly into the garden. We recommend planting them directly into your garden anywhere in between 6 to 12 inches between your little baby seedlings. We love to plant our Celosia very close together, so we plant ours 9 inches apart here at Pepper Harrow. They get really nice and bushy, but we want to make sure that they grow together enough to push them so that they get nice and tall. And we also want to make sure they bush together to shade out the weeds. So we plant our super duper close together here in order to ensure success. We hope this gives you some ideas of how to start Celosia. We hope you're successful. If you all enjoyed today's video, please like and subscribe. And as always, thanks for joining and happy growing.